In this series, I aim to give you a quick introduction to some of the plant families found in the UK. Learning to identify plant families is a great help in identifying individual plant species you come across. Plants are classified into families based on characteristics that they share. So, the way to identify a plant's family is to know these characteristic features. Today, we're going to look at the Papaveraceae, the poppy family. The members of this family are found throughout the temperate northern hemisphere, with a smaller proportion in the southern hemisphere and in subtropical and tropical areas. There are around 780 species, though some sources state higher figures. Most of them are annual and perennial herbaceous plants, along with some shrubs and a few trees. This family is important economically, largely due to Papaver somniferum, the opium poppy. This plant provides the painkilling drug morphine and related medicinal compounds, as well as opium and heroin. This species is also where the edible poppy seeds used in baking and cooking come from, and poppy seed oil. Some Papaveraceae species are familiar garden ornamentals. Many of these are poppies, like the famous Mechanopsis balei, Himalayan blue poppy, and its hybrids, Papaver somniferum, and the bright Eschscholzia californica, Californian poppy. Other examples include Lampropeptinus spectabilis, bleeding heart, with its unusual flowers, and the delicate Pseudofumaria lutea, yellow corydalis, and Corydalis flexuosa, the blue Corydalis. Papaver rheus, common poppy or field poppy, is a symbol of remembrance for those who have died in war, especially the First World War. In the UK, the Papaveraceae are herbaceous annuals and perennials, and include Papaver rheus and Papaver dubium, the long-headed poppy. Papaver cambricum, Welsh poppy, Glycium flavum, the yellow horned poppy, and the pretty and poisonous Caledonium magus, greater celandine, as well as Fumaria officinalis, common fumitory, Fumaria capriolata, white ramping fumitory, and Fumaria purpurea, purple ramping fumitory. The two subfamilies in the UK have different flower forms, though their structures have features in common. They have two sepals and four petals. In the Papaveroidae, the poppy subfamily, the sepals fall off when the flowers are young, so it may seem like they don't have any. The flowers are actinomorphic, regular in shape, and open. They are large and showy, with big, wide, colourful petals, often in shades of yellow or red. They tend to have a slightly crinkled appearance. There are many stamens, and the stigma tends to be chunky and divided. Unopened buds tend to droop on an arched stem. The flowers are pollinated by insects. The ovary is superior, positioned above the rest of the floral parts, and ripens into a dry fruit that opens via pores or slits at the top. This type of fruit is characteristic of the poppy group. The seeds are scattered as the fruits blow in the wind. In the Fumariidae, the fumitory subfamily, the flowers are zygomorphic and tubular. The four narrow petals are arranged into two inner and two outer petals. The outer petals have pouch-shaped spurs at the end next to the stem. The flowers are variations of white, pink, and purple. They have two stamens, though it can look more like six because of the way they're divided. Again, the ovary is superior and the fruits are dry, either a capsule or an achene with one seed. The leaves of Papaveraceae plants are often glaucous, meaning they are a greenish-grey or greenish-blue colour. They are usually lobed or divided and arranged alternately or in a spiral on the stems, or all coming from the base of the plant in a rosette. The leaf margins are entire or lobed. The stems and leaves of the Papaveraceae subfamily contain a milky latex that is white, yellow, or orange. So, if your plant has two or no sepals and four petals, big, bright, open flowers, or small, narrow ones, milky latex, lobed or divided leaves, and dry fruits, especially a capsule that opens by slits or pores, it's worth investigating if it might be in the Papaveraceae. Three species to look out for are Papaveraceae, the common or field poppy, with bright red flowers, often with dark patches in the centres, hairy, divided leaves, and rounded capsules with flat tops. Papaver cambricum, the Welsh poppy, with bright yellow or orange flowers, divided leaves, and elongated capsules. And Pseudophemeria lutea, yellow corydalis, a garden escape often seen growing on walls, with small, tubular yellow flowers, and finely divided leaves.